Hello there, Bale419 here, and I'm here I don't usually do this that often, where I just kind of sit down. I'm just gonna take off my headphones. I don't know why I still have them on. Like, if I don't have any audio in my ears, this is an awful intro, but if I don't have any, like, audios in my ears, and I hate audio in my ears, you have one of those, like, giant headphones. Like, it feels weird when you talk. Anyways, I don't do this that often, where I just kind of sit down. There's something in front of me, and this is actually a slide. Oh, you can't actually see the arrows, but yeah, you can see what this is about by the fact that I have a giant thing that says Call of Duty Advanced Warfare right on the screen right now. As of now, there's no music or anything in the background. If I feel like this isn't entertaining enough, because I'm not the best at this type of stuff, I will add some sort of music that I'll probably get yelled at by YouTube for. Even though it's copyright free or something like that, and they'll be like, "Ugh, how dare you? We're gonna get sued by Jesus." And yeah. Anyways, Call of Duty: Advanced Warfare. At lunch today, about 12 o'clock Mountain Standard Time, was when I heard of the game. It came out a couple hours before that, the trailer. Because I think for a while there are rumors of Call of Duty Patriots, which is gonna be set in World War One. And when I looked up the game, actually just a couple days earlier, when I actually was like, you know, I haven't heard a lot about Call of Duty. Went online, found out there was a bunch of stuff about Call of Duty Patriots. Turned out there was no Call of Duty Patriots. We actually, because they said it was in World War One, went a little bit ahead of World War One. We're in the year X. Whatever year is. I don't actually know. So this is the first game developed by Sledgehammer. The only problem I see with it being developed by Sledgehammer right now is that I think only a couple, it was probably only a couple months ago now, I don't think it's even a year ago, where it was actually announced that Sledgehammer was going to be working on the next Call of Duty game. So I don't know how long they've actually been working on it. The trailer, I'm actually excited for the game based on this one trailer. If 10 days before the game came out, they show me this trailer, and someone says, are you going to buy it or not? I'd probably buy it. This trailer looks really good. The only problem is, with these trailers, is that a lot of the stuff they show in the trailer is single player, not multiplayer, and Call of Duty is based on multiplayer. So that's I hope a lot of it's gonna transfer in. I'll get more into that as the video goes on, but I don't even know what I was talking about. Because Sledgehammer, if they only did have a couple months to make the game, it's not going to be a good game as far as I think. But from the trailer, it looks like they added tons of new things, new weapons, new just game mechanics from the trailer. It looked really good. It looked like if you got Titanfall, and then it made it better. And I know a lot of people like Titanfall, but there wasn't enough in there to keep you going back. Like, you play Titanfall, you'll play it for a month, and then you level up all the way, you prestige. I don't know if there's a prestige. I've only played it a little bit, but when I played it, I went around into menus, because I played at a friend's house, and when I went into menus, there wasn't much customization. So that's, I was kind of hoping maybe they'd add that. But they didn't. Now, hopefully, because Call of Duty is well known for having these, like, complex customization, like, even just with the crosshair on your weapons, I don't know if you could ever draw something on there, but I know they had quite a few selections of that, and you could create your own emblem, and, to be honest, the only Call of Duty I found actually really bad Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3 wasn't very good. It was kind of boring. It was good, but wasn't entertaining. And Ghost was just atrocious. And later on, I'm going to get into Call of Duty Ghosts if I find the disc. I actually don't know where it is, but if I find it, I'll get into that. And Modern Warfare 2, which is installed on my Xbox. It's been installed on my Xbox for a while, and I'll get into that. I'll get into the menus, and then I have a gameplay that I've already done. I'll just put that on the screen while I talk. Anyway, so we might as well get to the first picture. This is something I got off Reddit, where they made a slideshow. Now, this is a mech. I think this symbol here. Yeah, my mouse actually shows up on the screen. That's good. This, I hope so. I probably should have checked that first. Hopefully, that's not just on the preview. This is a symbol I think comes up quite a bit. I believe that is a squad. I assume either that or sponsorship. Either one. But this looks like one of the mechs, or at least something like the Juggernauts from the other games. Either one. If this is in Spec Ops and you had to fight that, that would be pretty cool. Especially if he had like machine guns or rockets, because he has like a normal gun right here. I don't see any like machine guns or rockets on there, but I think he did, maybe like out of his shoulders or anything. I don't want it to blow up the environment, because one of the things that Call of Duty is known for is compact warfare. Like with Battlefield, you have the expanded map. It's huge. You have long range. You're running. You get in vehicles. If they added that in Call of Duty, I think it would kind of take away from Call of Duty. Call of Duty. I feel like Call of Duty's best kind of distinct feature from the rest of the games is that it's not destructible, and it doesn't have any weapons. If it has mechs like this, or some body armor like this, where it blows up. Or it shoots rockets but doesn't blow up anything. I think that's fine. If they expanded max mechs and brought it, or expanded the maps and brought in mechs, I feel like that's going to take away from the Call of Duty experience that we have known from Call of Duty. Even though people do want tanks and stuff like that, I feel like it's just going to be out of place. Here you see. So yeah, here's the symbol again. I think that's the squad symbol. I could be wrong. You have the GPS or whatever on his arm. It's basically, this is kind of a generic shot. You have his weapon here, which just kind of looks like a it looks like a gun that's been like made futuristic but doesn't actually do anything extra futuristic. Maybe it has like, yeah, I think in Halo they had the how many bullets you have left on the gun, so maybe that's there. I think that was in Ghosts or Black Ops 2 or something like that. I don't know, wristbands. There's nothing really I can take away from this photo. This is pretty cool if they added this to multiplayer. But again, I feel like most of this is gonna be single player. Especially because I see the guy running like this. This is not how. I feel like that kind of movement would not be a feature in Modern Warfare or in multiplayer. So you see, this guy has like super jumping boots. I feel like again that'd be pretty cool, but it kind of, again, you would have to expand the map, and I feel like, I don't know, maybe you won't take away from the aspect of what Call of Duty is. Maybe you make it better, but I don't know. I feel like I could have go to a different game if I wanted that, and the fact that I stayed with Call of Duty means I kind of like that, because one of my favorite maps was Rust, and that was a lot because it was small and it was Nuketown. And again, that was because it was all small, it was compact, and there was non-stop action. When you're like, there's like 10, 15 minutes before you have to leave somewhere, you flip on the game and it's just non-stop action for 10, 15 minutes. And even if you leave, the next thing, if you leave in Call of Duty, it's so small and so short, the games, it doesn't matter. Which is a very good thing. Oop, went up. Yeah, if you want to read anything about what from this website, there you go. This, I don't know. He's on ecstasy. So that's all I can take away from this. I have no idea what the hell this is meant to be, unless it's like an Uber EMP, or maybe they have like electronics on them. Well, no, because if we go back to this photo, they don't. So I have no idea what the hell this is. It's like something on Tron. This is pretty cool. Again, I think it's only in single player because before he does this in the trailer, he looks at his hands. I don't see why when you run, it'd be pretty bad if you ran at a wall on multiplayer and the guy stops, looks at his hands, and climbs it. It wouldn't really make sense. So I assume this is just gonna be a single player feature. Or if they do, they probably change different aspects. But that looks pretty cool in single player, especially. I feel like a lot of camping would be taken away because people will be on buildings and they'll put like a claymore by the ladder. But then someone could just like wall run on top of that, and that would be very cool. But again, I think that's just single player. Here's Carrie Busey. Carrie, I don't remember his name. I've heard it like 50,000 times, yet I still don't remember his name. He was talking about how democracy is not working, it doesn't work for other people, and democracy is only good for America, and we shouldn't do anything along with that, and yeah. We shouldn't go invade other countries for democracy because they're not ready for it. And yeah, it's a pretty interesting trailer, and I really enjoyed it. The trailer will be in the description, of course, but yeah, what are you gonna do? Next picture. Oh, went ahead. Are you gonna load? All right, so there we are. We have kind of the futuristic choppers from what's that movie called? The one with the blue people, Avatar. That was it. He has a hat, GPS on his wrist instead of his shoulder, like the other guy. A gun with a silencer. Basically everything normal from the other games. Nothing really special that I can see. A bit more armor, but I don't think that's gonna make a difference. That's probably just visual. I don't think you're gonna have more health or anything. And then here you see a futuristic tank. So yeah, again, I don't see anything thrilling about this picture. I don't think you're gonna be able to drive tanks in or multiplayer. If you do, it's gonna be like one or two tanks, like a World of War when you could drive tanks. There's only like one or two in the map. And then we're back to this. And anyways, I also would kind of think of maybe mentioning it's gonna be a huge difference, the fact that there's gonna be actual 3 years. There's gonna be a 3 year difference now in the Call of Duty games. And not just 2 years like it was before. I think that's gonna make a huge difference because instead of them using the old assets that they've been doing, like I think buildings in I think Black Ops were the same buildings as Modern Warfare, a lot of them. But just because in 2 years you don't have enough time to reinvent the wheel. If you go to, if you 3 years maybe not even enough time to reinvent the wheel. But it's a start. Like a 3 years in developing a AAA title is enough time to make a decent title. 2 years, you're reusing a lot of assets, and because that extra year, you can make a if even if you make the same game, if you completely redesign it, you can use a whole year to completely redesign it. So maybe that's what they're gonna try and do, and hopefully they get around to do that. So hopefully they start doing that. I feel like that's kind of everything I want to wrap up in this part. I'm gonna go down and load up Modern Warfare 2 because that's my favorite game and it had like kind of the key points that I want to point out in the multiplayer interface and everything else that I feel like they should add in. So I'll be back in a second. All right, I'm back and I thought I'll just what am I saying? So this is I just guess I go back to the main menu. See, this is kind of how I feel like it should be, is you have the special ops here, which is kind of like zombies, if you don't know. It's the special thing that Infinity War did, way before they did like Extinction and the other one where the army people come attack you. Special ops was a lot of fun, and most of the stuff I've done is on the PS3, and then I figured out that the Xbox was better, and I got on the Xbox. So, yeah. Next. Oh, I need 69 apparently. Next unlock at 3 stars. All right. So they had Spec Ops, which I'm curious to see what Sledgehammer is going to bring out for that type of experience. So, cuz the Treyarch has zombies, Infinity Ward has about four different things. They just can't decide. Yeah. And then for the campaign, I have finished the campaign apparently, which I did not realize on yeah, museum. Oh, I remember this museum level. I might actually do that after. This is the game that had the controversial no Russian mission, where at the beginning of the game when you open it, it tells you this contains graphic content, and then as soon as you get to the level no Russian, tells you this contains graphic content, and then you go in there, you shoot a bunch of people. It's fun. But what I really want to show off is the multiplayer aspect of Modern Warfare 2. So if I go to Xbox Live, mostly you can create a class. Now, The greatest thing I liked about the Call of Duty series was how linear the multiplayer was. Because in Ghost, and it's been a while since I played, so this might be not completely right, but I believe all the weapons were unlocked, and you just needed to buy them with the in-game currency, which you got by leveling up and stuff like that. But really, you can level up, go for the best weapon, and just keep that, and never have to spend your points again. And I could be somewhat wrong, but that's how I remember a lot of. I think the perks were slightly different, but what you gonna do? So you had your assault rifles, and again, everything is laid out. So you had the AK-47. You knew the AK-47 was the best because it was at the end. It was level 70, and yeah, that's how you knew it was the best. And it wasn't like everything was unlocked and you'd buy it. It was all this is unlocked for you if you're new to the Call of Duty series and you didn't know how that worked. And this is basically how I would like a Call of Duty series to go. And he also had the riot shield because riot shields are cool. I don't actually remember what I had. I think this is the thing I had the tar in here. Oh God, what did I have? I'm never probably gonna play this game eventually again. I don't know. I'll put the silencer there. It's digital. This is before I made the classes named, and then I never went with that again. But this is basically how I would want it all laid out. Is like this. You have the shotguns, and you knew the model 1887s was the best because it was the best. And then they nerfed it. I don't like them nerfing it. I was annoyed at that. It's all very linear, as you can see. Everything is linear, except this is kind of a little bit off that track, but it's fine. Where you do challenges and you would get the Scavenger Pro, all that. And then you had the infamous, where is it? Commando. which everybody loved. And then you kill streaks was also something that I liked was, well, ish. Again, everything is unlocked for you, and you just chose which one was the best according to what you see people like Tabes and CNNers and Hutch did on YouTube. That was kind of how I chose my stuff, I believe. Oh yeah, so it's all levels again, so next unlock in 3 levels. Right? Next unlock at 3 levels, yeah. Oh! I think every time you leveled up, you got to choose which one to unlock, which I guess is alright, but it kind of, again, takes away from that. You have the emblems, which you'd get by unlocking challenges. It wasn't like you create your own emblem, which again, I liked. It was all, it gave you a reason to use, your challenges, which were here. And again, I feel like this is probably the best Call of Duty game for this. And I was actually surprised, even though it said there's 0 people playing, I was able to get into a third-person team tactical match within a couple seconds. And I remember that was hard to do. So, there's still a decent amount of people playing this game. But that was kind of how I'm now going to put the Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 match on the video, and I'm gonna wrap this up with my last thoughts and everything along those lines. So I'll see you in a second. All right, so I'm gonna just wrap this up. So this is gameplay off my, I think it's my first game back after however many years of not playing Modern Warfare 2, and I did a pretty good job. So I'm using the UMP with a silencer on. I have the Sentex grenade and flashbang or stun grenade. I think it's a stun grenade because I think the stun grenade is better in this game. It was quicker to release than the flash. I think that's why I used it. I'm using Scavenger, Cold Blood, and Sit Rep. That's what it says on the side there. Scavenger Pro, apparently. so I don't think I ever did one of these kind of videos where I just. Where I sat down and had a gameplay over top and I just talked about stuff. Or maybe I did, but I don't think I did it with Modern Warfare 2. Anyways, I thought I'll say, hopefully Sledgehammer can kind of revive the Call of Duty series. I hope so. I would love to see another game along the lines of Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare, even Black Ops. Black Ops, it had the money system, but it made the money system fun, and most of that had to do with the gun, or with, not just gun game, but the wager matches, where you'd put money in, you'd put the virtual money in, and yeah, but I feel like, because there's been a lot of games with, microtransactions, a lot of them on mobile, But I don't want to see that coming around to the Xbox and PS or PlayStation, because they decide to have in-game currency. Yeah, I don't know what else to say with this video. I'm probably just going to leave you with the rest of this Call of Duty gameplay of me destroying everybody. You could tell the seriousness in my voice. Anyways, I actually did very well in this game. Surprisingly well. I thought I was just going to get absolutely destroyed, but I did not. I was also surprised to see how many people were still on this game. I pressed it. I pressed the A button to get into a free-for-all game, and instantaneously, it got me into a game. So, there's still, I think there was like 72 games that were it was trying to join or something like that. Which, still pretty good. Yeah, so hopefully Sledgehammer had enough time to work on a game. Because I believe when Treyarch did Call of Duty 3, they didn't really have much time. 8 months, I think it was, and that's not enough for a AAA title. It's enough if I wanted to make a first-person shooter by myself in my basement. That might be enough to make a decent game that will give me a plus in revenue, but it's not enough for a AAA title. 8 months is nowhere near enough. So hopefully they got, because I think the biggest side in this is Infinity Ward to Treyarch, and then eventually Sledgehammer are going to get 3 years to work on the game, they only got 2 years before, and in that, because what you have to do in those 2 years, they're using a lot of the same assets and models and sounds from the old games, which is why it seems like it's the basically copy and paste. There's a decent amount of difference in there that you could tell whether a game is good or bad. It's not like, well, this game's the same as last year. It's like, this game is worse or better than last year. There's enough time to do that, but there's not enough time to add something innovative. In 1 or 2 years, you're not going to reinvent the wheel. That's what I'm hoping adding Sledgehammer will do. Even if there's like a year break in between the Call of Duty games, I wouldn't mind seeing that. So there's like Call of Duty, year break, another Call of Duty, year break, and it's gonna take a long time and people might not like it, but even for a couple of years if they do that, they might start reinventing the wheel, or even at least get a start. So, there goes my rant. I just actually think I probably should add that into the beginning of the video, the fact that the 3 years thing, so I might go do that now. Otherwise, I don't know. I'll have to look back. I don't actually remember a lot of what I said. That's usually how my videos go. My cat just stepped on my goddamn... No, don't do that, cat. Oh, God. My cat just stepped on the video, and I think he might have just deleted the video. Well, that's fun. Anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed, and I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.